your name?
Jane.
How old are you?
Five.
What did your daddy do?
Play football.
Who from?
Everton.
Is he good?
Yes.
What's his name?
Alec Young.
Someone who climbed over the railing and money as he went.
Yeah.
John Webster with the classified results.
Good
first for League Division 1. Burnley 1,
get
Chelsea 1.
Ghost cold.
Everton 1, yeah. Manchester City 1. The Fulham Sheffield United match postponed.
You're going out tonight?
Leeds United 3, Arsenal 1.
I'm Leicester speaking City to you, John.
Yeah,
Arsenal,
yeah, I'm going to dance.
Manchester
you're going
United
to dance?
One, Stoke City.
Don't you ever think of taking me out?
Every Wednesday 2, Southampton.
Well, you can come if you want to, yeah.
Wolverhampton
Wanderers 2, Coventry City 0. Division 2, Aston Villa 1.
Me and Owen, I'm here with you.
Cardiff City 0, Millwall 0. Abandoned after...
There's one up in here.
The Charlton Athletic Huddersfield Town and Crystal...
Will you get your tea? I wouldn't mind if it was only Saturday.
Derby County 2...
But it's every day, really.
North
when you are here,
two,
you just
one.
Sit there, you're glazed all
Black
over.
Black
so hurry up, because West I'm out
three,
tonight.
Oh.
But not with you.
Western Northampton 1, Bolton 1.
And I want to get all these dishes done, because you won't do them before I go out.
We'll get the cold on Mardi Gras.
Do you want to know where I'm going? I'm going to Bingo.
Oh, yeah.
Barrow.
What's that innocent curl?
My snowy coat. Yeah. Little leggings to go with it and a hat.
Oh, that'll be nice.
Have you seen what Mrs. Collins made for me?
No.
Well, she made some lovely things. Pram set and a few things.
What shade of them all?
Pink.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm banking on it being a girl.
Hey, Mo. Will you do us a favour?
What?
Will you have my shirt?
Well, I've got all this to do. Just leave it there and I'll do it after. I'm doing it, Mum.
Fuck it, take you 5 minutes.
Where are you going?
I'm going up to pub, business off. Sit down with you.
Oh, yeah, it will.
Hey, tell me something. What's it like?
What do you mean, what's it like?
I don't know. Goodbye.
Don't be horrible.
Fiancée.
What do you mean?
Oh, you know, do you, you get a bit?
What horrible are you?
Mum, quick, bring a call, ghost in my eyes!
Alright,
hang on.
Oh,
hurry up,
man! Can you not keep quiet out there? Can you read?
Why don't you?
Oh, the bloody noise is like a sudden mother.
Hey, look at that!
I'll murder you.
And don't pull the chain off again.
If I get stuck, I'll give you a shout.
And don't stay out there all night, there's others to go.
God,
only
one out.
Hi, Sid.
Well, it's not that big gobshite again, is it? Every time you're bleeding up when you come here.
I think this is coming down soon, isn't it?
Yeah.
In your place.
It's built on the slum. Well, you know that's last week. You're like a vampire's haversack.
It's not as bad as this.
Shut up and read it.
Make the mice walk down there in overalls.
Ha ha ha.
Hey? Don't take the curtains down. We haven't read them yet.
Clever.
Who is that low here that you get cockroaches walking around with humpbacks?
Who likes these people and these matches? I don't think he was at the match, this fella. No, Miss Mallory. Did you see it?
Yeah.
Natalie. Really killed a jet in Stanley Park. Hey, they're not doing so well somewhere, are they? They don't know much with the bear at the echo. See me the air on the leash.
You can't.
Oh, no, I couldn't go out looking like this. It was like a house.
Just for half an hour?
No, couldn't really.
Really?
Well, everybody would be staring at me, wouldn't they?
Drop.
So
getting
early
tonight.
Oh, alright,
alright.
Yeah,
Mum. Who's the unlucky fella?
No, he's no lucky for hairdresser.
Who's the same fella the other week?
Yeah,
what's
him?
What's his name? Rupert?
Well, I tell you all, leave her alone. Go on, love. You go and enjoy it.
Go on, you
start calling me. Come with me, Dad. We'll have a rave up to
Christmas. I'm not the person you'll go out with.
I believe he's a bit of a tat, isn't he?
Is he?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
well,
yeah,
you go, love. Well, I'm off then.
Yes, you go and enjoy it.
Well,
Will you look at this stage again? He looks as though he's going to work, even though he's going.
Oh, well, we'll have a quiet night now.
Just don't have a cup of tea.
Yes, yeah, please.
I'll go and put the kettle on while it's gone.
Well, in my opinion, Alex Young is the greatest centre-forward we've had since the war.
Alex Young, what about Tommy Wharton?
Tell me how many goals he's got since he's been here. Go on, tell me.
Who are you?
Yeah.
About 30.
50 up to last season he got 54.
54.
Goals.
54. Score. In how many seasons though?
In six seasons.
Did he get 60 in one season?
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying. That was effective with a big man in the middle. That's my argument.
He said to me, as soon as you're come on, I bet they put it on the deck now.
Yeah, well, when they beat Manchester United, you weren't saying they were all big fellas then, were you? Or, the sign of no God in the world. No, but they didn't.
Yes,
they had the same board now except for Royal. They had the same board now except for Royal, didn't they?
When they're short of someone, who do they call on? All the time, Sandy.
Would you have him in the team every week? Who would you put out? Go on.
I'd put out Wilson.
You put out Wilson?
Yeah.
You want an England back?
Yeah,
for Sandy Brown?
Yeah.
Get off. Get off on yourself.
It was all right, but the World Cup's made them stale.
Joe Mercer, T.G. Jones, Watson, Torry Gillick, Bentham, Lawton, Stevenson and Boys, and sometimes Jimmy Caskey on the wing. The finest Everton side I ever saw. They won the championship, you know.
No.
1938-39, and no one had ever heard of a Liverpool or a cop at anything.
I remember saying it.
No, son. The greatest team that they had was in 1906. We had a lad there, as Scotty was.
Yeah.
And he was the finest player on the field.
Who was that then?
Scott.
Alec Young.
Alec Young? He's the centre pole today.
Yes. That's the only one you know, but they had an Alec Young that day. Honest John, they called him. And when he dribbled down that wing and scored that goal, the greatest lad in the world.
Alex Young, the
Alexander
you?
Young, yes.
When was that then?
He came from Stirlingshire. In 1906.
Have you? Who's on first? Come on, Cole!
Yeah, not like that,
you know. Come on, Aiden!
Yes! Normally, the beginning of a week of training, you do most of your hard work, your stamina work, and the latter part of the week is done more or less for speed and agility.
How is your gun as you're coming up? How is your gun?
Yeah,
that's it, up to the line and walk back. Walk it back, nice and easy, start relaxing. Come on, Ernie. Right and left. Jump in.
Right, off you go.
Up
to
the right. Up! Left! Up!
Good. About 21 years now I've been training. In the olden days, all you did was more or less running, lapping and that sort of stuff. But now, training now is done considerably more with the ball than it's ever been done before. The boy can now come from school to here, and his future is assured, providing he becomes this kind of a football player.
Now! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, arms up! Arms up! Right up!
Heels!
Come on, heels!
He can train when it's wet, he can train inside, because they've got the assets here for to do it with. It's practically another home. It's home from home.
You're not concentrating on the ball. And when you put it through your legs, I want you to go 3 or 4 yards quickly. So
but you're really making a move. You're dragging and going. All right, now, off you go. Come on now.
Dive. Too long, Gordon.
Take it out first, Roger. Take the ball first. The next play is back.
It's a good career, providing he's a good footballer and providing he's dedicated to the game.
Either one of the two of you now can break, not the front man breaking and the back man chasing. Can we just have it just open a little bit because we are inclined to be pushing the circle in? This is the last time for this one now. First time, yes, right? You're on now. First time it's going to be, that's it.
Change him up! Go on, Brian, change him away! Yes, come on, Austin, tunnel! Tunnel! That's it. Keep out, Ray, keep out! Keep out! Keep out! Keep out! That's it, hold on, go on, Hayden, hard! Hard across! Hard across, come on! Hard across! That's it, hard across! Come on! Keep it going, you're on! That's it, come on, keep it moving! Hold your back, hey!
Stand it, press
it! Keep it up! Keep going! Four, press it! One, six,
and two, seven, try to get the ball! Come on,
I've got to
try. Keep the camera on him, he looks well.
I was born in a little mining town, really. Just outside Edinburgh. And we always sort of played football when we were kiddies, knocking around on the street, kicking the ball around. And I never thought I'd ever be a good player. I was always mad keen and never thought I'd ever be professional. I used to always think professionals were all posh people, a way above what I could ever be. My folks, they were just an ordinary working class family. Went to the mines, served an apprenticeship as an engineer, and played part-time professional with hearts. I used to enjoy it quite a lot, you know, because it was sort of a change. You were going to your work and training at night, and then you had a couple of days off in the mornings. I used to enjoy it very much, and I don't think it made any difference to me in fitness. I felt just as fit being part-time professional than full-time. When you're full-time professional, you have a lot of spare time in the afternoons, and you get bored and drinking cups of tea, and I don't think it does you much good. Next week sometime, maybe somebody comes along and then you're transferred. I don't know any professional footballer, it feels absolutely secure. I think this is a point about professional footballers, we all feel very insecure. Because it's a job, it doesn't last forever, it goes all too quickly. Or if I play well, I'll read it in the newspapers. If I don't play well, I don't read the newspapers. I don't need anybody to tell me, any press reporter to tell me I've played badly, when you know that all too well. I think I'm a bit erratic sometimes. When I'm on, I can play as well as anybody. When I know I'm playing well, if I feel well and I'm playing well, I think I can compare with anybody when I'm playing well. And sometimes I sort of drop down to the depths of it. I can't understand it myself. I've tried to think about it, but it just happens. And sometimes I'm not as good. Other times I'm quite good, yeah. I finally played football. I'd have been staying in the council house. I'm working in the mines as an engineer. Doing reasonably well, but not with a great deal of prospects. I doubt if I'd had a car. I'd have sort of just settled into the little village bank life, you know. He's still in the mines, my father. He's worked all his life in the mines, except for 6 years in the army. Now and again I go to a local school and do a little bit of coaching. I find this it's very rewarding. In the afternoon I went for an hour and took about 30 kids for football. And I felt that at night I felt that, well, that was worthwhile, that I enjoyed that day. Other days when you've done nothing, you say to yourself, what's it, is it worthwhile, what's it all about, really?
shortly, I would love to be a coach or... It's a dodgy game, really, but maybe be a manager someday. I've still got 2, maybe 3 years in the first division yet.
Well, I drive this this truck. I do 3 different sort of trucks at different times. The main one I have is this one, which turns around the floor, picking up odd things. But I quite like it, you know, because you don't really have to work very hard on it. That's the point, you see. I can save all my energy for the end of the week.
Well, I stay here. It's steady, isn't it? I mean, it's his regular energy. What's steady range you?
Well, I felt it being some form of engineer or mechanic. But once the contempt believed in school and dad right away, you know, started looking for a job for me.
Good trade. That's all
they
can say to you. Better trade, you know. And I wouldn't want to know. It gets a bit tough. Yeah, we're going pushing the entire round to get monotonous. But there again, I haven't got any qualifications. He often tells about going away to the sea or joining the army and stuff as a read. So, one thing I've never gotten to the rest of this. You know, some of these people are really common the way they speak. I try to keep myself above that. It's not qualified, but there again, we had a good laugh, you know. I ran over a fellow's foot last week.
The way I contribute to back in Britain, the great effort I make, I lifted the tyres, the tyre mould, the tyres have just been moulded, they're big, they don't look like tyres, off the conveyor belts from the big machines, onto a truck, and God knows what he got from that.
Are you ready? I've been waiting for you.
Same status before, eh?
Okay, lad. Name, easy one this time. Name the 1939 Everton football team.
Easy. Seager, Peace, Greenhalgh, Mercer, T.T. Jones, Thompson, Gillow, Cumley, Lawton, Boyd and Stevenson.
That's fine. And?
They held a trophy for 6 years after the war.
About the thing, you know, when Dixie Dean scored the 60th goal.
In 1927 to 28, we were playing Arsenal. The score was 4-3. It was 8 minutes from the end, I remember that bit. He scored a goal from the corner, from the corner.
That's right. Now then, can you remember who scored the goal? Who took the corner?
Yeah. Alex Truth, he's dead.
Oh, you did, eh? Well, it's not that one, he's all right. Now then, good day.
Right. He played for Everton 1 week, Liverpool the next week. But, not a chance of beating his hand.
No, you've got me. I'll have to give up.
St. Vincent's Bank. I won.
What are you earning now?
£4,000 now.
Well, we've got to have a scoreless check of it. Can you change your mind about notes?
I think it'd be sensible on Saturday to thicken the centre of this field by playing 3 men in here, pulling Sandy Brown back. You have players like McClintock and Samuels who do a prolific amount of work in midfield. And with that in mind, we'll have one player brought back out of the front four, playing in front of our two normal midfield players, Colin Harvey and Howard. I think this way we will gain more possession in midfield.
The forward man, which is basically Joe in this situation, you know,
yes.
Having not got a lot of support, I still feel it's better if he keeps their defence as far back as he can so that our 3 men can operate much closer midfield and can come from the back to support him in this situation.
Corner kicks, basically Joe, we would take the far post,
both taken to the far post. The short one, Alec, you come to the near post, laying it back.
With this corner, particularly John, I think. You know, John, if we go early for this, it's obviously that you're getting too close to the line from the Alec flick. I think it'd be better if you come a bit later from the centre of the field. Then that's leaving you then, Joe, with a whole of the six-yard box on the far side of the back half of the goal to come in onto.
I think if we persist in these tactics on Saturday and maintain a pretty high work rate, we'll come away with a couple of points.
From behind that Everton goal now, as Everton sweep away again, Alex Young through to Trebilco, can he get a shot in? He can't because the whistle's gone. But here comes Gabriel now, striding forward to Trebilco, turning it inside. Alex Scott is spotting the national outside right. A beautiful little move inside there by Scott to Gabriel, away to Everton now. Trebilco, the scorer, can he get another one? No, he can't because Young's victory intercept there as Alex Scott takes his free kick just outside the penalty area. Into the penalty area it goes. There's LeBone's hit for it. There's a shot by Trebilco. A goal!
I was up all night because of spam butties.
Three tins of spam shibboleths.
Three tins,
great big tins like that.
Every time I tell the bloody story, it was next to a tin. There was a little tin about that
big. No, it wasn't, John. It was up and down this night. Some fellow came up to him. Said to him, how about your passport?
He's never thought about passports. Everyone knows about passports. And what about you, Joe Hannigan and Brian Croft all sleeping on our floor because they were supposed to be with me in Milan.
And Seymour Hannigan wanted to know where the present was from Milan.
Well, she got a present.
Went to Milan and then we brought them up the back.
Where did you...
Well, now, no, we're locking this house, I'm not joking.
And where are you off to next week?
London, I ask no. Yeah, smoke.
I suppose you'll be going in the van again.
Can you go too?
No, you can't go.
Just your man.
No.
No,
you're not going.
I went to Bill in Manchester United and Wolves. I can't go to London.
I don't care where you went. You're not going and that's the end of it.
Let him go,
Alex. You'll be in the alehouse. Where will he be?
He can sit in the van, can't he?
Look, John, he's 12 and he's not staying in the van all night on his own.
I've saved up for weeks and weeks.
I don't care how long you've saved up for, you're not going.
Oh, I'll go on a sweet of mist for just then.
I don't care. You're not going. And don't keep on all the time. On. Now that's the end of it. I don't want to hear any.
Please, Mum.
No, you're not. And I don't want you whinging and moping around this house all week.
I am.
You're not.
What?
Give it to him.
Let him go.
Oh, you ought to have more sense anyway.
He'll be all right, I've told you.
He's not going. How many more?
All right. We've heard it. Don't argue with the bloody
night.
That one.
Yes, well, he's not.
Holy Ghost, Amen. God bless Gordon West, Tommy Wright, Roy Wilson, Brian McBride, Colin Harvey, Howard Kendall, Alan Boyle, Ryan Alkshaw, John Hayes, Amy Horn, Cindy Brown, Jimmy Marcy and Jimmy Husband. God bless all these heirs. God bless my dad, Evans, Karen, Muriel, Sylvia and Doreen. God bless our cat. 9+1. God bless me. God bless my name. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Amen.
How's that, man?
Well, Joe, you're on the belly.
Down a bit.
Plenty of love, please.
Oh. You're not working tonight, eh?
Yeah.
Well, are you going to get down to London?
Well, it's wrong in the morning.
What, certainly not yet?
Yeah.
Oh, you'd be shabby.
It's you, Mum.
No,
I'll get my head down on it too.
How come you're in so early today, anyway?
Yeah. I had to go and pick up the van from our kid. He's lent it me for the weekend.
The way you're going to do it, aren't you?
Yeah, man.
The size of it.
It's a bit big, but at least he won't get scrambled.
Hey, you played the match in that and still got the card in there.
You have one before you go?
No, I'm late now. I've got to get up to work. Are you going in for a kiss and a cuddle and a farewell? Bye-bye soon, huh?
Yeah, we haven't spoken since last Tuesday when I told her I was going. I should expect her when she sees me on Sunday, I suppose.
You get battered when you get home.
Yeah, I suppose you drove on bigger than she is.
Hey, about the game, where will you see
her? Oh, I don't know where. You better make it beyond the goal where we were last year.
Right, if you go away from home, you've got a point and the idea is to keep it. It's for the home team to come and take it off you. And you can get a point away, as instead of saying it's 2 points at home, one away, it's championship form.
Let's face it, the game's got so big, results mean everything now. You get one or two teams like West Ham. Everybody wants to play West Ham. Simply because they know you're going to get a good open game. I'd like to see more teams like West Ham playing.
There's an old saying in football, you get the first hard tackle in the first minute, it makes the forward think about where you are for the rest of the game. I've never tried to intimidate anybody like that, it's not my style, and Ray's the same. I prefer to put my skill against the opposition, but in some teams, I think that's what they're told, to go out and cripple or club whoever happens to be the star player on the other side. People are going out there playing under pressure, knowing that the result is all important, and football has been sacrificed for results, and that's not all of my decision to retire, but that is part of it.
I don't think it's a fear of not having success, isn't it?
It is.
There's many footballers now in the first division that really enjoy the game.
It's not as much as it is. I mean, you can't enjoy professional football 100% because it's...
I certainly don't enjoy it, I guess.
Well, all I know is the chap I'll probably be against, Graham, is very good in the air. And I just have to be watching that particularly. I mean, he's quite a clever player, actually, for his size. But all I know is I'll have to be up high in the air to try and combat it.
Do you know that?
Don't forget the air. Come on.
Hey, Johnny, put it out for the back.
Put the van. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
We've been there when we get stuck into the mallet and out.
Yeah.
Just had the lot of them.
I'm just going upstairs and stuff.
Are you sure you're all right, Mel?
Yes, thanks. I'm upstairs.
Okay. Now watch yourself as you go up those stairs.
I'm just going up to the toilet.
Do you want me to come with you?
No,
I'm
alright.
I could kill our Vince for going today of all days. I'm sure she'll start tonight.
Do you think so?
I'm sure of it. She's been complaining of that back, hasn't she?
Yeah, she said before it was bad.
Well, when you went up the stairs before, did she say anything to you?
She didn't, but she was in the bathroom for ages.
Yes, because I think she's had a show.
Do you?
And I'm sure she has, and
she didn't say anything about it.
No, but I mean she's going to have a bad time.
Do you?
Yes, I do. She's been compelled with that back. We've had a bad time, you know, over here.
I'd like a cup of tea. Oh, please. As soon as you come round, you'll go screaming now and come back telling on me.
Is that okay?
She's upstairs. My name isn't Bob. You know, she thinks she might be bad tonight.
Oh, sure.
She's not in the room, isn't she?
No.
Where's Brian?
He's working late.
Isn't going down bad?
Oh, he said he'd follow them all.
Yeah.
Just a weekend, I don't know.
Yeah, so.
Can't wait, can I?
No.
You can't.
Where's the man?
They're gone already?
Already they've been gone, yes.
I'm fed up with your father. I'm fed up with this house. And I'm fed up with our Vince. We don't want to get you down. So we can't help it. It's football.
Yeah, I know that.
Well, it's a man's game, isn't it?
I don't know why they don't take up golf. Let me change.
I don't.
I've never had one of these before. I didn't know they'd give me one of these. The diesel engine, you see, not a petrol.
Well, what's the difference?
What? Well, you see, if it had been a petrol, you could have got at the carburetor and the ignition, you see, but this works on pressure. And the injection pump, you see, right. I took the front of the circuit and I have a look at the, see if I can see the pump, you see.
Give me the bloody hell for that. You've got to go, that monkey.
What's that shooting?
Great idea, isn't it? No train first, back there. No better pocket, no time.
Yeah, well, guys, like with the Ava like we've got now.
Alright. Yeah. Because you've got to give it to Java, haven't you?
What?
You know, the ideas he's got better than this line up. I think he's a smashing one.
Come on, we've got it all done.
Well, I can't wish you luck, John, until I find out this bloody punk, can I? Like?
Hey, have a look. Marcus has sent to get away early tonight.
Yeah.
Sure. Tell you what I do, try and catch the move, man. I've got the runs all night.
You can run to 7 o'clock in the morning, then. It's only 5 o'clock.
And my guts is bad.
Not only your guts, you're bad. You've been bad for months. Come on, go with the bloody job.
Oh, there's a big coon up in the missus when you get home.
Come on, then. Wakey, wakey. Rise and shine. Come on, there, come on. Come on, take your feet out your mouth.
Come on.
Hey, Archie,
a
big
bench
with you.
Right, then, now look, lads, we might be here for some time, you know, our kids work me a bunch, dear, so, anyone who wants to, just on the off chance, lads, they better try and hit your lift.
Yeah, blimey, you're a
girl, you're a nice man. You're not that bad,
Archie,
you're
looking at. Hey, look at you, your missus just gone. Tell Vince and his wife to the maternity. Hey, look at you.
Respect you, Adam. It's a whole life, the team in football. I've got quite a lot of affection for them. I like to do well for them. I don't always do it, but I try and do well for them to please them, you know.
Fans really saw what went on the dressing room before a game, you know, the actual tension the players go through, and it opened their eyes a great deal. I mean, Gordon here's usually, more often than not, he's actually sick before a game.
They're going to enjoy playing at home this afternoon. 3 o'clock on until 25, I just can't wait for it to finish.
Sometimes I just feel as if I couldn't do anything playing football, and other times I feel as if I could do everything.
This was a great day. 1-0 we won. You scored the goal. A smash it was.
1906.
I went with my dad. I was only 12 then, and our Billy was 14. 40 special trains they put on. 40. Because all the fans were dedicated then to them, you know. We all slept on the station, packed. And then in the morning we got the train to the Great Glass House.
The Great Glass House?
Yes, I'd never seen this Great Glass House before. Oh, it was massive. All crystal glass it was. Beautiful. And the place inside, just as big as what Goodison is today.
But how did the ball hit the glass? Why would that?
I couldn't hit the glass. It was too far away then. I can't remember much about yesterday, but I'll never forget about the 1906 Cup Final. 21st of April, 1906 it was. That was the year of the big San Francisco earthquake. A terrible disaster, that, but it was a disaster for Newcastle that day as well, when we beat them 1-0.
Oh, my God.
John gone now, was he?
Hello, John.
Hi.
Hello,
John.
Hi.
I'm not going to go to the pictures. There's gold on off the street.
Gold.
I haven't seen gold. Have you seen it?
Joe.
Have you seen gold?
Joe.
Have
you seen gold?
Joe. We've seen more than gold here, haven't we?
Creative. Passionate. Exciting. Miss Marta Hatari.
Well, he made some fantastic saves. I think the greatest one was that one, I think it was McClintock. He hit it from like a rocket, right into the onion leg. And he grabbed it with two hands, right down the post, and ends up on the net himself. So that's fantastic.
Killed yourself gassing her, didn't you?
Sorry?
That's it.
Hello. Where's your dad, fella?
It's your dad.
Hey.
Oh, I'm here too, aren't I?
Say hello.
Hey! What do you think of him?
This morning?
He is not. Look, stop splashing.
I've got a shot in the throat.
Oh, that's bad, isn't it? You shouldn't have bothered coming.
I'm knackered, you know.
Oh, hi. Oh, it must have been really, you know, hard work, you standing cheering everyone on.
It was the hard work.
Oh, yeah, it must have been terrible for you.
Who's been?
Your mum, my mum and dad. St. Vincent's band, they've all been except you. They're disgusted at you. Well, I think you've got to say a kiss, mum.
Come on, give us a kiss. Mm. Yeah.
Just
kidding.
How dare
she, you? Have
you been to Solo? Yeah, I've been
there. What a club. This one, bad, bad. The nut, yeah, as you see. 16 supers. Marvellous it was. And the ale, a dollar a bottle, it was like nuts.
I've got a bottle.
It's edible, isn't it? Have you been here, have you, Mrs. Way?
Yes. Let's fix your property.
When we get to the factory, on Monday, then if the blows will work, you can walk around with your head up in the air, can't you?
The first recollection I have of it is when my cousin took me to the boys' pen, and I think it was 1946, and I think Evert were playing Derby County, and Jock Dodds scored, and I think it was 1-0.
You used to have special tunes for the football games, you know, football on the front, and you get on the knees, and it was the sort of a way out.
I can't remember, actually, when I started going to it. I mean, I've known it all my life, really. When I was a kid, me out to a grasshopper, my dad took me down. 1933, I saw the Everton team being brought back along Scotland Road in a carriage with Dixie Dean holding the cup. Now, that's my first recollection of going to Everton.
I don't like going to a derby game. I don't remember missing one for years. Because I seem to have a shaking feeling when every time Liverpool attack.
I don't even bother buying the football like I will when we get beat. I'm just too sick to read all about the game.
The biggest punishment when I was a kid, if your dad didn't let you go and say I've had no Liverpool.
I was chucker when Nixon left. I didn't go to the match for about 6 or 7 weeks. And then I only, after that, I always remember going and thinking, you know, the bastards. And I think you feel like that with the team.
The only thing that gets me is you don't see any sunshine, you know, you wouldn't know what time of day it was.
It's just one of those things.
You've got the boss on your back at business, you've got the ref on your back at home. If you can go and cuss your players to the referee, it does you no harm. If you leave it cussing, I think it does you a lot of good. It's a mix of sport, big business and show business. It is basically a sporting function.
Look, I'll put it this way to you. Supposing right now they said to you,
yeah,
you're Mr. Catherick.
Yeah.
Here's the Goodison Park ground. You're in charge. You've got all the players.
Well,
all
if
the
I was Everton manager for a week, I pick a team, win every game. Win every game.
Oh,
we'd win the league with clubs on. We would.
That's what you're driving a truck, isn't it?
No, I'm not a popular fellow because I've always felt that if a decision has to be made, I mustn't consider whether it's going to be a popular one or not. I think the fellow who looks either for popularity or tries to be a martyr in his way, there's something wrong.
I think that if you give this autonomy to a manager, that you give him all the money he wants, allow him to buy who he wants, make the blend. If after a period of perhaps, I would say, 2 years, 3 years, if he has not produced the results, he is not the man for the job. And I think that he should have no hard feelings about it if he is dismissed and another manager obtained.
Well, what do you think this new fellow in hand?
Well, it's hard to say. I mean, I'm not saying he shouldn't have brought him. Where's the bloody hell he going to go?
I think when you're about 18, you think football, professional football is a bed of roses. You know, you think everything's great, everybody is great. After a few years, you become a bit hardened, and you realise it's not really that good. It's a hard grind. You have to take a lot of criticism. You have to forego a lot of things in your private life. And I think when you after a few years, when you wake up, you think, well, maybe there's something better you can do.
The grassroots of the game. Ireland is in the villages and in the streets where they play football, would agree there. So a lot of the best of it is working class, but I'm saying it's a much broader basis now. You get some really very well educated boys coming into the game because they can see a career for themselves, you see.
One of the tragedies of the modern game is this factor that we have quite a lot of gifted ball players because of the accent on ball control in modern football, which the public are not really seeing, mainly because of the destructive attitude of some players with lesser ability.
I know there's a certain amount of hooliganism for the moment in it, and a lot of ill temper, but I feel that this is far better than having race riots and having political riots. I think a lot of people do like to let the steam off and to shout at a football match, and even curse a referee is better than race riots. I do wish people would leave referees alone, but still, remember, we are human beings and we have the emotions, and the football, I think, is a very, very great game indeed. And I only hope its name won't be dismissed in any way at all, but it is a great game, and if there are small blemishes, let's not worry. Let's say that, generally speaking, it's a very good game which does a lot of credit to Britain.
We do have, of course, a certain amount of property, but houses and that, but they're probably not. Like all these things, they don't show quite their full value.
If our break-even figures are about in the terms of 33,000, we're averaging about 40,000, we're making money all the time. Now, we usually spend that, most of it, improving grounds, buying our sports ground, but we've got to the end of that now, and we normally make money. We must have the best facilities in the whole country. We have money in the bank, and we have investments.
Hey, Mr. Haven, what's up?
Hello, John.
Oh, are you all right?
All right, Ed. I'm all right.
did you get the bug out?
Well, the lucky fella got that down. He contrived me to, you know. Only got four bob rebates, of course. Mind you, there wasn't much in it.
Do you want me to get you anything?
I gave me a cup of tea, lad, will you? John?
Yeah?
The tea's in the tin box on the top shelf.
I put the can on, Mr. Hagen. We'll have some tea in a minute.
Wait, John. John, where's the blood on that dresser? Is she a black boot there? No, not that one. On the other end, that's the one. It's a singing book. Open it, will you? And read from the night. So it's in there.
Sam Fagan, Wyndham.
What's it?
Simon. Chirachiron. Very good, B-17. Very good, B-17. You didn't tell me you was a sailor, Mr. Hagen.
No, I'm not a sailor, sir. Seaman, bridge and seaman. Sailor makes you think it's too, sounds too much like the fellas. 1909 to 1919. 10 years I was going to sea.
Why did you stop? Go to sea?
Everton. And then I met a child and got married. And then there was no work after that.
No work?
Then I started to look for an employment committee. That was for all the lads that wanted work and food. And we were a fellow named Tittyman, we led us. And then there was Tom, he was an ex-scupper, was Tittyman. And then there was Tom McQuigger. He was a fine fellow. He went to England on the boats like me one time. So we couldn't get any work anyway, so we went on a hunger march to London, 1922. You see that photograph on the mantelpiece there?
Yes.
Well, I'm on there.
Are you on that, Mr. Egan? Well, I that we go to London, Mr. Egan.
You go one of these times. I hope when you go, you don't go like I went. Hardly any food, no boots, hardly any feet. And Everton doing too well either then. Well, Everton were doing well, I was doing well. And when they were doing badly, I did badly. They won the cup in 1933. And I got a job at Roots. And then they won the league in 1939 and I was just getting on my feet nicely. And then something goes wrong. Our Billy died in 1944, and my wife Nellie, she was killed with a bomb in the same year during the war.
Hello, Jerry.
Hello there, Tom. How's
the
war, buddy?
I think I'm off to Dad.
You all fellas have a fine old time, but you know, no problems, no wife, nice little pension. Pictures in the afternoon, bevy enough at night.
You really try to be rich, don't you?
Yeah.
Hey? Soon as I get my boots back from the Menders, I'm away on the yacht. He's down the road.
I'll come with you.
Have a few bob, would you?
Yeah, a few bob took away.
Look at that.
What?
Oh, the curtains have gone. Well, the cat mowing.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know Billy Thompson down the bottom end of the street?
Yeah, I know Billy, yeah.
Sent his cat a Christmas card.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I knew she liked cats even when she was up to Cooey.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from Kit Thomas to Timothy.
Yeah. Really?
She's screwing. Rolling.
Round the bend and halfway back, eh?
Right up the wall.
She probably got some rats in there. Anyway, yeah.
Next
see ya.
See ya. Come on, Patrick.
Shut that son door, will ya?
Dad.
Well, Raz.
Mummy is in here.
Is he now?
He's in the parlour.
He's not.
He is.
Jeez. Annie?
Yes,
the
I
police
have.
Here.
I'm coming.
God, the second time these fellas come, we're going to be out at the dogs or somewhere instead of visiting bloody people.
Yes.
What are you going to see him anyway?
Well, you look a pretty picture. Oh, come on, Dad.
I'm good at running away, you know, scummy.
Yeah, why don't you go with him?
But why would I see a sudden
well,
police
Well, you should go to be ashamed of yourself. No, Andy doing the same. He never goes to mass.
You don't go often, do you?
Yes, go on, Vincent. Go and see him and you're with the new baby.
Oh,
well,
you never go to mass.
Well, I'm your mother, aren't I?
Blimey, what a place this is.
Just come for a minute, John.
Hello,
Vincent.
Hi, Father.
Welcome. I was just saying to your father, Vincent, we never see him at mass on Sundays.
Yeah. We don't see you either.
Well, Father, I mean, it's hard, like when you,
When you're lying in bed, you mean? Oh, yes, I know. Just like your father. Your father's got the same trouble. I've heard all about it.
Oh, it's not a case of lying in bed, Father. No, we're not making excuses, but we do our best to get there. John, you want your bevy, Father?
What?
We have a bevy, a drink. We have a bevy.
Oh, yes, thanks. Yes, I will.
No, I'll go and get you one, won't you?
Well, you're right, Father. No, it's all right. You're all right, Dad.
Well,
Get him.
Can't leave his own,
can you?
Yeah, Father.
Okay, what was that?
I've just told you to get a large one, Father.
Sit back.
A large one.
John, you know, you haven't been to mass since Vincent and Carol were married.
Well, I didn't realise it was that long, Father.
Why?
It didn't seem that long.
It never does, but as time goes on. Of course, now they're expecting a child, aren't they?
Oh, well, she's had the baby.
Oh, she's had the baby?
Yes, Father, a little lad. Little Evertonian, you know.
How long?
Fortnight ago, Father.
Has it been baptised yet?
No, in a fortnight, Father.
In a fortnight?
Yes, well, I mean...
John, dear, the child should be baptised as soon as ever it's available.
Yes, well, we couldn't get the bed in time to be any quicker.
Well, you'll be at the christening, no doubt.
Oh, Jeff, oh, I'll be there.
All right, I'm sure seeing you, John, at the christenings and the marriages and the deaths.
Oh, yes,
one thing.
Yes, Father.
You should try and get along on Sunday mornings as well.
I'm sorry for not going to mass, it's not my fault.
John, don't make excuses to me.
No, Father.
It wasn't me that died on the cross on Good Friday for your sins.
No, Father.
So don't make excuses to me. Anyway, how is the family?
Oh, they're fine.
Do you know that young
man? Leslie Jammy.
Ah, grand lad. John.
Well, yeah, it's the other one I'm worried about. You know Vince, who's known for the beer?
Yes.
I'm very worried about him, Father.
Why?
Well, I don't like the company. He's coming in late, and I think he's at it. I mean, I'm not talking around his back.
No.
But you know when his wife was, well, you know what I mean, Father? I don't know how to say it to you.
Come on, speak up.
Well, he was carrying on, I think. I'm not sure, but I think he was carrying on with girls and these gangs in town, you know.
Gangs? And in this parish?
Good man, Vincent.
Yeah, Father. Thanks.
Cheers, Father.
Cheers. Have you mentioned anything, Dad?
Oh, I never did anything else, Father.
Oh, I see.
Give the Father a glass. A glass, yourself, sad. Sorry, Father.
That's all right, John.
Don't
worry about that.
Don't be stupid, sir. I've really had.
I've drank out of a bottle before, John. You mustn't worry about that. Good luck.
I couldn't see that at all.
But if we have a prayer, lads, then if we have the I believe, because you see, you have to know the I believe when the child gets baptized. You do, yes. The child gets baptized, you see, you have to say the I believe now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, crucified, dead, and buried. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Come on.
Rachel called to say.
Oh,
I'm
hey, Mum.
With me always going on about your dad going to the matches.
Yes, and I do.
Well, who do you support?
I support both teams, but
teams?
Everton and Everton UK.
What's holding on, Jack? Can you think? Why should she be this?
There's something wrong here. I'm not supposed to be worried, is it?
The ones I know about, she turned up late. I'm so worried to go to a bloody football match.
I think I'll be bloody Saturday. I only got what it was. Stand unpunctuality.
They are like you with the boys round the building. You can never steam off at the match. You don't get bloody messes as you drive along with you. The director's boys there, we don't know what team's playing who. As I said, they're by the bloody lot.
William Frederick Slater will now take Alice Janet Morton, here present, for thy lawful wife. I haven't finished yet. According to the rites of our Holy Mother, the Church.
Come on! What? What in heaven is going from here, you bloody idiot?
Is this the bridegroom's family?
Yes,
it does matter. Oh, for God's sake, come on, let's get organised. You just stand there. Right. Are you ready? Where is he?
He's in, I want you on the pulling up his mouth.
So I'm in the move up. Hold on. It's not cinema, sir. Come on, just a bit closer. Come to see your bride. That's it. Look as if you've married her. Yeah, a bit closer, come on! Come on, hurry up now!
You're hiding the
camera.
You're
hiding the
camera. Come on, look at the camera.
That's all right. Nice big smile. Right at the camera. Beautiful. Good. The bride and the bridegroom and the two bridesmaids. Could everybody move out of the way? Look now, look.
I'm getting paid for doing it. I've known it's amazing. I mean, you know, you're only the best man.
I've been asked to organise this. Now, come on. Bridegroom, bridegroom. Could everybody move over this way, please? Come on, hurry now. I don't want to rush you. But everybody can stop. Let's try to go back, but they move further down.
Are you expecting to go somewhere or something?
You made a right cock up with this car, honestly.
Could you just clear the back, just away from the side? That's I just want to get through these cars.
That's lovely.
Nice smile, man.
That's beautiful. That's
nice big smile.
Don't shake, sit, please. That's nice.
Lovely. The camera.
Beautiful.
Well, could you come in and shake hands? Could you just get the side, please, if you don't mind this time?
You can take him more time, that's what's necessary, I'm sure. I don't care, who's paying for it?
That's smart, that's lovely. Very smart.
That's lovely, yeah, that's beautiful. Is he sorry, Father? Did you hear that the way? I'm awfully sorry, Father, honestly.
Yeah, well, when I tell you the first one was to kiss the bride. Nice little kiss, all right? Nice big smile.
Nice big smile. That's beautiful. Nice.
Can we kiss the bride, please?
Okay, right. Oh. Let's go.
Okay.
If you've had enough pictures, forget about it. Come. Forget about it. Give us some park and step on it.
Right.
Hello, where is he?
Well, Mr. Hagen's dead.
Dead?
Mr. Hagen.
this afternoon the other day.
You know, his last wish, you know, he always said that when he died that he wanted his ashes to spread on the ground.
You ever heard him say that?
Yeah. Well, they wouldn't let him do it, naturally.
Do you know what he's doing?
Yeah.
Oh,
well,
he
didn't
care.
Yeah. They're driving him around the garden.
No.
Yeah. Before the funeral.
Come on, John, let me go.
Yeah,
I've had a bit of trouble this week.
Yeah,
I've got one or two injuries.
Yeah.
And why would you like to play centre forward?
You ain't going long.
I'm very pleased to do that for
you. Very good.
Very good.
Let me stop.
Yeah,
yeah.
Film director John Borman, and on BBC4 in just a minute.